Thank you very much to welcome me. Thank you, Olga. Thank you, the Office of Patent in Serbia. It's a pleasure for me to share with you about my experience. Because could you imagine that in 2002, we were two in the big governmental organization in France, looking for how it is possible for us to commercialize, to promote patent, to do technology transfer. It was now 15 years ago, and what we do at that moment, we went in the US because it was the first boom around patent. It was after the first book of Kevin Rivet. It was Rembrandt in the Arctic. The book says that maybe you have a lot of patent and some of your patent are very good golden nugget. You have to extract this patent and to commercialize. It was at the beginning of the story of IP consulting, IP valorization, technology transfer, and so on. It was in 2002. It was the beginning of the autumn. ASTP was not existing, and so on. We went in the US, and you met a lot of university, Stanford, MIT, and so on, to understand how they are doing to promote and to commercialize patent. We come back in France, and we were in a big organization. The big organization is the CEA, Commissariat à l'énergie atomique et énergie nouvelle. It is a big organization in France with 15,000 people, half of our researchers, with a huge patent portfolio of 4,000, 5,000 family patents. And my objective at that time was to commercialize and to get money back from this huge patent portfolio. Okay. The first 3 years, we extract patent, infringe patent, and we assert the patent against the company on a worldwide basis. It was the most easy part of our job, okay? Just to extract patent, infringe patent, and to go to the people, to the company in the US and in Asia, and just to ask for compensation because they use the patent. After that, after 3 years, it was more complicated for us because even if we have a huge patent portfolio, this patent portfolio has not a real value for the industrial. Each time we prepare technology transfer, we package patent, we acknowledge and so on, we approach the industrial to say, yes, it is interesting, yes, you have expertise, but your patent portfolio is not good for us. And we understand why the patent portfolio is not good, because we have a lot of patent in your technology and you say it's not good, it's not ever good. Yes, because the patent was just only search to protect the result of R&D and not the business objective of the company. It's really different when we are a researcher, you just search to protect R&D result, or if you take in consideration the business of your future client when you will have to transfer the patent and the technology. For such reason, we decided to educate the people in this huge organization to think about when you want to file a patent, you have to understand your competition, you have to understand your landscape, you have to understand the patent portfolio or your future target, you have to understand what they are doing with their patent, okay? And after that, you have to align your strategy to file patent with the strategy of the industrial. You have more to protect business than to protect R&D, okay? R&D is nice, it's beautiful, technology is very beautiful, but you have to protect the business, okay? To think about a competitive advantage we will push to the industrial at the end. It's not only to go to the industrial and to say, yes, I have patent, yes, I acknowledge everybody in the world have patent, everybody is acknowledged. But if you think that I arrive and I have a very good competitive advantage for you for such reason, with such arguments, it's very different, okay? It's very different. And now the industrial company have a look, and you raise the chance of success to transfer the technology, okay? It's at the beginning, even if it is a fundamental research, okay? Because when it is applicative research, it's more easier, because you know where is the market, you know where the company are doing R&D and so on. When it is fundamental, it's more complicated, but you have to think about that, okay? It is more complicated, but you have to. And we educated, we developed in the big organization different methodology to help the laboratory and the inventor, the researcher, to take in consideration the business objective. After some time, big corporate company in France and other country in Europe came to us and to say, yes, it is very interesting what you developed for the CEA. Could you help us to implement such methodology in our company? We say, yes, why not? Because we are able to do for us, we will be able to do for you. And after some time, we think that maybe we develop something to create a new spin-off, okay? A consulting company. And we decided in 2009, we were seven people at that time. In 2009, we decided to spin off the activity and to be a consulting company. The share was mainly owned by the CEA. It was 65% of the share was owned by the CEA, and the 35% by the salary. Okay, and we decided to spin off this activity, and we grew the activity of the of this company until 2013, and we decided that now we were ready to go on a worldwide basis and to do the job for other companies in the world. And it was very difficult with the CEA on the board, and the CEA decided to sell his share to a private company, okay? And I identified the company Questel. Questel is a very old company in France. They develop a software database about the patent, okay? And very good analysis tools. And we decided to join this company in 2014, okay, and after together to launch this activity. It's more, Questel was a software company, we were a consulting company, and now we imagine we are a solution company, okay? We bring to the company not only software, but services and consulting and so on. It is what we are today. Just imagine, 15 years ago, I was one of you, and it seems it's very good because the market today is very huge for consulting in IP strategy. John, share my thing. But the market is very huge. If tomorrow you are able to reproduce what we are doing, it's not an issue for us, because the market is very, very, very huge. Just now, because it is important to understand, I come back to the group Questel quickly, 10 minutes, and after I will come back to this part. What we are today? Bring IP to the board. It's a motto, the main motto. Bring IP to the board. If you want to make IP a real business, you have to convince the board of the company, you have to convince the board of the university, you have to convince the board of the funds, you have to convince the board of the startup, okay? If you are not able to convince the board, it's not an issue for them. You have to do something else, but you have to convince. And what you have to convince? You have to convince that IP bring value, okay? Bring value, and you have to put figure in place of value. It's not value, yes, patent is very nice asset, you can bring value, but which value? How I can make money with patent? You have to demonstrate it. I will show you that it is not so complicated to show what to demonstrate, okay? It is very important, it is a motto of the company. Now what we are a company with 200 people, 50 million, but mainly we are a software company and a solution company. Okay, we have a tool, patent database, we have analysis tools, and we have services, and we have consulting and e-learning. Okay, just quick look. I don't want to do the publicity of the company. Questel company today, it's 40 people. We have the consulting part of this group. Okay, you are IP strategist. We are based mainly in Europe. Now we are extending our activity in the US, and you are in China and in Japan. The background of the people in the company are engineer and PhD, okay, with the MBA to understand the business, okay, and they learn about IP, because today it's very difficult to learn in university IP. We have to teach the people in the company. Okay, and there are specificity in such a field of area. Okay, now what we deliver, it is services. Yes, it is for the IP department. What is very important, it's in the middle, it is for the innovation and R&D department. We work mainly 80% of our job is for innovation and R&D. It is very complicated to work with this guy, because they see you as a competitor. When you want to help, to do consulting, they see you are a competitor. No, this guy are very interesting by what we propose. I will explain you why, and after it to help the company to better manage the IP process. Just about some services. It's a basic services. It's very low cost services. Today you have such services with an Indian company. Okay, it's very low cost services. Here it is for the innovation. I will explain you later what we do. It is use and market splitting for you. It's very interesting because how you use patent publication to identify new markets for your expertise and for to transfer your technology. It is just to understand very well a landscape. When I am an industrial company, I want to enter a new market, and so on and so on and so on. Here, player well matching, I will explain later. And that is more about the right organization. We do diagnostic audit, and we have the activity, the name is job as a service. We coach people in the company to do what we are doing, and after we transfer our methodology, okay? Because the market is huge, okay? And a lot of big companies want to do by themselves, okay? Better than to say, I want to sell my prestation, my services. No, you want to do by yourself. We are okay to transfer our methodology, how we do the analysis and so on. In the same for you, if you want, we share with you the methodology, it's not a problem. I was a former TTO, leader of TTO. I know very well your point, and if I can help you, it will be a pleasure. Justina, it was your talk, when you say that tomorrow we will put consulting services and so on. I am very open to discuss about this point. Now, come back to the subject. IP marketing and startup, all become an interesting business here for investor. Take 1 minute, please. Okay. Fund understand the value and the importance of intellectual property. I precise, some funds understand the importance of IP, okay? Fund were investing in seed and early stage technology. They understand the value of the IP. Why? Because they reduce the risk with the freedom to operate. If you translate the freedom to operate, is the amount of money you will not have to pay to have an access to the market. If I don't have the freedom to operate, I put a lot of money in R&D, and at the end, when I want to put the product on the market, I will have maybe to pay a license, if it is possible, to access to the market. For an investor, it's very, very important. I'm sure to differentiate and ensure future market share. It's really, you understand very well. You have to protect your main differentiator. Okay, when you will put a new product on the market, you have to protect what will be your differentiator. And if you are strongly different from the other product on the market, you can put a price higher than the price they use today. And after, to reassure and increase value for the next round, because it's very important. to keep in mind that when an investor go in your company for the first round, maybe 500,000 and 1 million in your company, they think about the next round. The next round will be in four years, maybe. And at that time, to have in the table a very good set of IP will be very powerful to negotiate the value of the company for the next round. And we have to work with the fund and with the startup to raise the IP portfolio of the company, thinking that for the next round we will ask for a lot of money because the startup have a very small patent portfolio. It's with such a philosophy. Just I will come back later in the day about this study. In France, the university and the fund, sovereign fund, the name is France Brevet, make a study just to understand if a startup has a bigger chance if they own a patent before the first investment. Okay? If you have one patent, and after the chances you multiply by three, the chance of success. What is the chance of success? It is if you are you sell your a second round, LBO, or if you sell your company in a merger of acquisition, and so on. It is a success. Okay, three times the success. And after we will go deeper. If you have one patent, it's not because you have one patent. It's because the management is very aware that IP is important, it seems. Because at the beginning, the first patent is a startup, the value of this patent is very low, it's very bad. We will see later. People are very happy because they have a patent, or they have two patents. Yes, yes, I am the king of the game because I am a startup with two patents. But at the end, when you diagnose the value of the patent, 80% of the value of the patent is close to zero. Okay, but it's not the case, because the people is very aware about the importance of the patent, and when you say that he will do the best to protect his R&D result about the trade secret and so on and so on and so on. You raise the chance of success. Triadic patent, just if you have patent in different country. Okay, triadic in the US, in Europe, and Asia. Okay, if you have three patent. Portfolio score. You use different criteria to qualify the quality of the patent. Okay, if the patent is a good quality or not a good quality, and why the quality is not so good and the quality is good, the chance is multiplied by 4. And if you have a cluster of patent, is better than one patent. Clear, one patent is nothing. You need to have 2, 3, 4, 5 patents at a minimum. Okay, if you have a portfolio size, you multiply by 5. Okay, it's very very important, and the investors think about that when they want to invest in a new startup. But when I speak about the funds, it's in France we have maybe 250 funds. Okay, but we have a different stage. Okay, when you invest in a company, but we have only 15-20 funds very specialized in technology. Okay. When I speak fund, it is such kind of funds, okay, I speak. They know very well. And how we work, I try to know. Okay, how we work with fund? We have a business model. It's very interesting, the business model. I share with you the business model. Because what we do for the startup, it's expensive for the startup. Because at the beginning, a startup has no money, okay? And they want to put the money in technology, in equipment, in people, but not in IP. At the beginning, not in IP, okay? And just to have a diagnosis and to have an audit, it's the last thing they think about, okay? But we have a deal with the fund. We don't try to find a startup to promote what we can do for them. It is a fund. The fund identifies some startup interesting for them and asks to startup go to Questel Consulting, okay? And they will do a diagnosis, okay, just to understand what is your patent today. They will help you to define an IP roadmap. I will precise what is an IP roadmap after that. And we'll give you a result of the. If at the end the firm decide to invest in the startup, the startup will pay us with a part of the money the fund put in the company. Okay, it's nothing for the startup. If the fund decide at the end that they will not put money in the startup, the fund will pay us. Okay, the cost for the startup is zero. It's clear or not?
Yeah.
Okay, it's clear. Okay, the cost for the startup is zero. After, you have to convince the fund that what you do is very powerful. But now we go. What is the methodology? It is a quick description of the methodology we do. When we have a contact with the CEO and the CTO of the startup, first we have to very well understand our business plan. Okay? First is the business plan. Second is the new product or the new service they want to launch on the market. Okay, very well understand what are the objectives, what is the competition, what are the differentiation, and so on and so on and so on. And after, the first is to break down the new product in different silo. Okay? For such example, it is a new startup want to produce a new battery. Okay? A new battery because maybe I don't know a very very nice characteristic. And what we do at the first, we take the product, we break down the different technology, for example here electrode and material and shell, because it is very important for the electrode, and the collector, electrolyte, battery building, coupling. And now we are beginning to diagnose the IP position of this startup at the beginning of the story. If it is green, it is a strong asset, okay? And after it is red, it is a very bad asset. And now we have to do the diagnosis, okay? It is what we are doing. Alors. First, what we see, the people come and say, yes, we have to patent. We have two patents. We have patent protecting material for electrode, a patent protecting shape for electrode. Yes, good. Two patents at the beginning. It's not a bad news. It's a good news. Okay. And after, where are extended the patent? The patent are well extended in the right territory. Okay, because the market, I don't know where the people, the manufacturer is. Maybe it's in a suit in Asia. And if the market of Asia is protected, in Europe maybe one, two, or three countries, and in the US, for example. Yes, it's a good news, but it's not enough. It's not because we have two patents, because a patent, what is the objective for the patent? To forbid the other to enter the market. Okay, you have to go in depth analysis on this patent. And first, we have to assess, it is two criteria. I give you two criteria as an example. Two criteria, if it is easy to turn around, okay, the patent, to do differently. If it is easy or not to prove the infringement. Okay, because if it is not easy to prove the infringement, the value of the patent is very low. You have a patent, okay, but is it difficult for you to prove the infringement? What do you want to do? If you have an idea, give me. But I have no idea. If it is easy to bypass the technology, for example, you use, I don't know, maybe ampere and no volt, I don't know, nothing, it is very easy to turn around. I can write another claim, and for me, it's not an issue, your patent. And we have to assess the validity of this criteria. It is two criteria I give you as example. Patent number one, bypassing possibility. We work with a CTO of the startup. We have to imagine how it is difficult or not to bypass the technology, to turn around the technology. The conclusion is very complicated. You have to. We have no idea at that moment, and maybe it's very complicated. For the patent number two, there are several possibilities. Ah yes, just ask the people when you have a patent, if you have to reproduce the same thing but not with the claim, just imagine. And the people, you will see, half of the time people, oh, it's very easy. I can do like that, like this, like, okay, next step. Okay, bypassing,
You're talking to the inventors about these possibilities.
Yes, with the inventor. Yeah. The other, infringement detection. Okay, for this one, it is impossible for the first one. I can't prove the infringement. It's impossible. How do you do? I don't know. For the other one, it is very easy. Okay? What is the conclusion about the value of the patent? Zero. It's clearly, it's zero. The real patent point is null. Okay? It's not a problem, it's not an issue. If you go to the fund and to say, yes, we don't know the value of the patent, and the value of the patent is zero. You say, yes, okay. But now, what we will do? Okay, what we have to do? I understand. I am very confident with you because you come back to me and you say, yes, you have two patents and the value of the patent is zero. Yes, next step. And after. But just to show you that patent is not all the IP. Okay, and after you have to assess the other IP owned by the company. Oh, sorry, I'm not very good. Okay, first is the know-how. Okay, the know-how is very important. When you speak with a startup at the beginning, they say, oh, the know-how, wow, we have a very big, very huge know-how. We have a it's a very. After we have to discuss with the people, yes, but to know that a know-how must be keep secret, okay? You have to formalize the know-how in the document, okay? Is it done or not? Not done, okay. It's not a know-how today, yeah? It's not a trade secret, it's not a know-how. Okay, when we assess after the know-how, we saw that, yes, they have a very strong know-how, but mainly published in the patent description, okay? They have a know-how. But when you read the first patent, you saw that the know-how is very well described in the first patent. Okay, the value of the know-how is zero. Okay, it's no value because it is described. Okay. For the second, there is strong know-how not published in the patent, but easy retrievable by reverse engineering. What does it mean? Huh? It means if I buy a product, I do a quick reverse engineering and can easily understand how they do the product. Okay. If it is easy, the know-how is very low. The value of the know-how is very low. Okay. You have to very well understand. For the electronic, there we see that the know-how of the company is very strong, keep secret, okay, well documented, and so on, and so on, and so on. It is about the know-how. If you have remark, I am open to your question.
Can you define a closer strong know-how? What's a strong know-how?
Keep secret, well documented, okay, and with a good differentiation, okay? Because if it is secret and well documented, but the value on the product is zero, it's not valuable. The know-how, for example, it's the time, the people, your competition will need to do the same thing, okay? For example, you can imagine if you are a startup and you are in competition with Samsung, Samsung will be able to put 100 people during 6 months or 1 year just to understand how you do the job. But the cost for Samsung will be 100 people for 6 months or 1 year. It's very costly, okay? And after, maybe they prefer to pay for that, because it could be very costly. You have to assess the know-how. But after you have to do the job for software, design, and all the IP assets, okay? Just to finalize the diagnostic of the company. Okay, it's the first part of the diagnosis, okay? It's not so complicated, huh? It's time for us to do such job. It's maybe between 5 to 7 days. Okay, it is discussion just to assess and so on and so on and so on. After, I will give you the cost of when we sell a prestation like this one. I will ask you how many you are ready to pay for that if you are a fund, and I will give you the response. But now you have the diagnosis, but you have to understand the IP landscape you are entering, okay? Because, now we are just considering your IP asset, okay, for your project. It's an internal diagnosis, and now we have to understand the landscape. What about the competition? What about the other development, ongoing development? What about, we have to understand a lot of things. Because I am an investor, I put a lot of money in the startup and I want to have a lot of money. Because if you ask to the people, to the startupper, they will describe the environment as they want to describe the environment. We do neutral, we give a neutral opinion about the environment. What we can see here, that you can see, it is an example. The number of patents is growing rapidly. Very strong interest in this technology. Okay, it's very good news for the investor, because the good and bad, but better good, because if a lot of people, a lot of company invest in the same time, in the same product, and the same technology, it's a good news. My choice, it could be good. And after, where are based the company who are developing the technology? You can have a full overview of the where are the R&D center and which country the company are protecting. Okay, you see now we have a full access to all the information about the different exam in the different countries. Okay, we can see if some patents are in litigation, we can see if patents are opposed by other company and so on. What we see here, there are a lot of opposition. Opposition is what? It's company who make an opposition to the granted, to the granting of a patent, okay? Because the company thinks that this patent could be blocking for the development of my technology, okay? I have put an opposition on the patent. If you have a lot of opposition, it's good, because a lot of companies are working on the same and defending the patent position. It is very good. The first infringement case, okay, the market is growing, okay, it's nice. Litigation are emerging, the aggressiveness. And after, you have a look on the Marjorie, who is doing R&D work at that moment. No surprise, in each technology, each field today, the emerging company are the Chinese player.
How do you find data for first infringements and litigation processes?
Because we have an access and because after it's not to do promotion of the tool, but now tool is not a patent database. It's a patent database with analysis, and after that we add a lot of information. And now we have direct link with a producer of such information. The name of the producer is Darks IP. Darks IP, it's a company, a Belgian company. There are people in all courts, all over the world, okay, and they take all the decisions, okay, and after they organize, it's a, okay, not a patent database, but it is a litigation database, and you have all the information about all the opposition, all the litigation, and so on. It's very, very, very interesting, because you have the arguments when the patents are or not litigated. And now it's a full, it's a micro analysis of the IP environment. Okay, I am an investor. Take the place of an investor. Yes, I see that. Yes, good, not so bad. And after, go to the next step, because it's not enough. It's a micro analysis. Now we have to come back to the silo. You remember, the protection we have for each silo. We come back to the silo, and we focus now. Now it is a focus. Here it is a macro analysis, and now we have to do micro analysis and to focus on the silo, to very well understand what is happening in this silo. It is just an example. For electron material, what we see here, we identify some very interesting patterns, very close to the subject of the startup for electron material. What we see? We see that a very interesting patent is owned by Battel. Battel is like a university, okay? It is not a manufacturer, okay? This patent could be interesting for us if I can get a license of this patent or if I can buy this patent as a startup, okay? Because it is a university, probably the cost of the patent will be not very high, okay? If I come back to you and I say, yes, I have 100,000 euro, I give you today, and you buy your patent, what you say? You say, no, maybe 1 million? Oh, no, I don't know. For me, when I was at your place some times ago, when the people come to me and say, yes, I have 100,000 euro, I know that the researcher has an interest. The researcher says that maybe he will win 50,000 euro for him. He come back to his house, he discuss with his wife, and we have, do you accept 50,000 euro or not? If the people come back to you and say, no, no, it's very strange, huh? Okay. No, mais donc, it is very interesting to what is it? A trust. Okay, I am very
good. Say goodbye to the computer. Okay,
thank you. No, maybe I don't trust you.
No,
that's good. But I do. It's for you, huh? For my PC is here, huh? It's your PC, huh? It's not mine. Huh? Okay, enough for what I see. This one is a competitor, okay? I understand that they own two patents. Maybe blocking patent for my development, okay? Because they are very strong patent covering a big part of my product. It could be very, very embarrassing for me. Okay, you have for each silo, you make a focus and you have a very good understanding of the main risk and opportunity. If you have one opportunity, maybe to have a license from Battelle, and maybe you have two blocking patents you will have to think about what I have to do, okay? And we will see after. Maybe I have to invalidate the patent, maybe I have to turn around the patent, maybe. It's not because you have two blocking patents the project is dead. Because, for example, for 3D printing today, if you want to launch a new company in 3D printing, if you have a look on the IP landscape and the patent landscape, you say, yo, bye-bye, no, never for me. Because there is a huge amount of patents, but it's not for such reasons that you don't have to go. We worked for a startup company, and the landscape was very, 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 very annoying. And what we see in the landscape is that Rexroth law company, a US company, was with a big amount of patent about the technologies the startup want to develop. And we have a contact with Rexroth. We ask if they are ready to out-license their patents. They say, yes, we are ready to out-license the patent for such amount of money and for such share of the startup, okay? And for the investor, it was very nice because you are in board now, Rexroth, and you are a very full patent portfolio, okay? Main of the case, you have to do something and we do something. If you consider such strategy, It's always a good way to find a way to develop your activity. There's, I don't know, maybe we do such kind of a job for 30, 40 startup a year, okay? And maybe one or two, just the fund decide not to put the money, okay? It's a low. Okay, come back to the end of the diagnosis. Okay, what I see for electrode, potentially two blocking patents. Okay, for the shape, no blocking patent, good news. For the collector, as the company will bought the element, okay, it will be the issue of the supplier to manage the IP position. For the set, for electrode, we saw several potentially blocking patents, but still pending. Okay, it's good because now we have to do a position. Okay, to this patent, you have to search prior art document and to do a position. And after, no blocking patent. But it is very complicated here because it is how to manage the battery. It is very complicated to detect the infringement. Maybe this patent here is not an issue at all.
How do you determine if the patent is blocking and how much it is blocking?
Because you have a technological roadmap, okay? You define a technological roadmap with a researcher, what they have to do to reach the objective, the characteristic, and maybe when they saw the patent, because we bring the patent to the inventor, you say, yes, we identify such patent, what do you think the patent are blocking or not? I am not the inventor, huh? It is the inventor, you say, yes, it is blocking or not. It is the inventor, you say, yes, because the claim is very, very good claim, large claim, and it will be very difficult to turn around because, wow, it's
So you do it with inventors?
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Rather
yes.
than with patent examiners?
Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. No, we work very close with the startup. Very, very close. We are not the divinity. Okay, you have just we have just a methodology to deliver at the end a report of the. And after what we use a marketing tool, you know, mainly. It's a SWOT analysis. It's a very normal by BCG, McKinsey, and so on. It is just about the strengths, the weakness, the opportunities, and the threats. Okay. And last, it is a resume of what you see during the diagnosis and during the landscape, macro and micro. You will have the slide. Just now, you have the resume of the diagnosis. Well, maybe we can go deeper in the remarks, but it seems that it's not. Just strengths. All technology to a table because the job is not finished. Bypassing of blocking patent is still feasible. Okay, we work with engineers. They say yes. We have an idea how we turn around the patent. Okay, do you imagine how it is important for the investor when you come back to the investor with such information? We identify blocking patent, but we have idea to turn around the patent, and we will file a new patent in the next 2 or 3 months. Investor. Oof. It's the freedom to operate. If I don't see that, I will. I push a lot of money in R&D, and at the end, I will have to pay to get a license. And the rentability, the profitability of my project is a wrong. Okay? Weakness. They have weak patents. Okay? They have real expertise only on one silo, and no more. Only 2 competitors. It's good news. Some interesting patents are linked with the startup business and are owned by research institute. It's very good news. Be very good news for 2 reasons. Because I can get a license of this patent, and I can imagine to collaborate with this company. Okay, if I want to boost the R&D in my startup, maybe it's better to collaborate with a university and so on. For such reasons, it is very important to have a patent portfolio. When you see people ask me yesterday, well, why CA has a 6,000 today family patent? For the visibility. For the visibility. Today, when the people go to MIT, MIT has a lot of patents, but it's not a subject for the MIT because the brand is enough strong to do the job by itself. Okay? But for the visibility is very important. When I am an industrial, I am looking for competency, capacity to help me to develop the product. I have to identify who owns the patent. And if I see such universities working on such products, I will approach the university, okay? And the people come back to your university and say, tok, 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 I see you have 1 patent, maybe we can, your patent is not very valuable, but it's not the case. I am more interested by your expertise of your team. Maybe we can imagine a collaboration. And for you, it's very powerful. Very powerful. Even if you don't have 6,000, but if you are very strong in a field of a technology, don't hesitate to file patent. Even if it is a bad patent, because a lot of people think that if you have just a Serbian patent or offer, it's not a valuable patent. It's not the case. If you have a translation in English, the people, when we do the job, we do text cutting for a lot of companies. Text cutting is what we are looking for, competency to help the company to develop the product, okay? And we do. At the moment, when we have a translation, even a quick translation of the content of the patent, it's enough for us to say, such a university could be interesting, okay? Blah, blah, blah. Okay, and about the tricks. And after that, we have to build what is the strategy. Okay, now we are in the diagnostic. What is the strategy? What is the situation? Here, lot of red, yellow, and just few green. Okay, what we want to go to be green. But all green, maybe it's difficult, but more we will have green part, better it will be, okay? And now we resume the objective and the strategy of the company, okay? It's very important. We are in such situation, we want to reach such situation,
and the strategy of the company in this one. When I say the strategy is, we have to accelerate the product development. Okay, it's very important to be the first on the market. Okay, if we can identify competency, it could be useful for the development of the startup. It is what it is, the strategy. We have to reduce risk regarding FTO to reassure the inventor. We will have to do something for that. And probably we have to think about how it's possible to generate new cash flow. Okay? New cash flow is just when you draft a patent, you think about your product, you think about your market, but just think differently. And just imagine if my technology could be useful for your other market and another other people. Just to think like that, maybe you just draft another claim and the value of your patent for another manufacturer or another market will be very, 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 very huge. It is just okay. And after that, what is, I resume the strategy, okay? I have a SWOT, I have the strategy of the company, and I have to take action, okay? When you take action, you have four, how you bring value to the company? You reduce your risk. Reduce the risk is a license you will not have to pay, okay? Clearly, when you think, you say to the investor, reduce your risk, yes, reduce your risk. Everybody say, yeah, reduce your risk, yes. But it is a license you will not have to pay. What is the cost of license? In 3% of the total turnover, okay, yes. What is the amount? My perspective is maybe 100 million. If I have to pay 3%, the margin of a product is 10%. If I have to pay 3%, it will be 3 million less in the budget of my startup. Yes, I understand. Yes, yes, we have to do something for that. And for that, what? You have first to take a license from Batel, okay? And because we see some blocking patent, we have to think about to design around the patent, okay? The next step. Here, you have the time, the time frame. Today, tomorrow, and after tomorrow, okay? You have to decide, I have action to take, but I have startup, I have not a lot of resources, I have to prioritize my startup. Here, I have to file a patent, because when we discuss with the CTO and so on, we see that the people have a lot of ideas, we have to protect the idea to file a new patent, and so on. Here, we have to extend the patent right to relevant market, okay? Here, we have to write to identify white space, to identify where is the space I can find new patent, and so on and so on. And as it helps, I have to monitor continuously the patent landscape, because it is a situation at T0, okay, but maybe tomorrow or after tomorrow the situation will be very different. And now we have all the job, because we have the algorithm, you have the keyword, we have all the things, you just have to connect with a good database, and each month or each week you will have a result of what is happening regarding the patent landscape. And here it is for sustained competitive advantage. It's very important. Sustained competitive advantage is a marketing term, okay? But we have to translate in business terms. Business term, if I am the first on the market, if I have a very strong characteristic, maybe I will be able to sell my products 10% more than the price of the products. 10%, the price of my products will be 100 euro, 10% is 110. 110 multiplied by the number of products I imagine to sell, it is a real fact for a figure of fourth investor. Okay? Accelerate development is very important, because when you have fund, each 3 months you have the fund around the table and to say where we are, and we have to accelerate, you have to boost. And now you have to think about a partnership, for example, and so on. And you see that the patent are not good, the two patents they own are not good, we can say you have to abandon the patent, you don't have to pay. Maybe not in the first year or the second year, just the time to find new patent, okay? But after, you will have not to pay to extend the patent. But for the firm, it's very important too, because it is money I don't have to put for nothing, okay? And after, you do the result. It is the result of the diagnosis and the audit and the IP strategy. And when you come back to a fund with such kind of information, it is very valuable for them, because the fund is ready to put maybe 50,
500,000 or 1 million, 2 million, 3 million, okay? And just to have such kind of information when you invest in a technological startup, it's very important. What is the price we ask for such? Just give me an idea. The pricing for such
analysis
until now. Until the we can stop here. Okay, we have a price. We stop here.
Terms of dollars or percentage or
no, nothing. Just a cash.
20,000.
Huh? 20,000. 20,000.
20,000. 5 to 10. Five.
No, 20,000 until here is the price. Okay, 15 is here. Okay.
Do we get a discount from
this? Yes, you can get a discount. Yes. No, it seems expensive or not?
It depends.
No, but if you are the startup, yes. Yeah. Yes, sure. But if you are the funds, because it is not the startup, they request a diagnosis like this one. It's the fund. For the fund, it's nothing. When you are ready to put 2 million or 3 million in a startup, it's nothing. It's 20,000. Yes, okay.
How many people are working on this?
But it costs more than 20, does it?
No, it's a price.
That's a price?
Yeah, it's a price. 20. The number of days, it's 20 days. Just to give you an idea, when we sell a people, it's 1,000 a day.
Estimated 20 days.
Yes, 20 days.
Do you have people working internally on this or also externally? So how do you get experts?
How many people are doing one simple company?
How many people? We have two people working on such project.
Two.
We have a senior and a consultant, an analyst.
So all is done internally? Yeah?
It's internal. Yes, we work with subcontractors. We have a network of subcontractors. Today we are 30. I saw you. We are 40 people in the world. We are 30 in France. France in Europe, but close to France. We are establishing a new GV in Germany and in other countries. And yes, but we have typically now, because we are doing such kind. Yes, I forget to explain you. At the beginning, it's 15 years ago, when I was a leader of the TTO, I was in a group. Okay, and the group had two main parts in the group. One was for commercialization of IP, and the other for launch of new startup for the CEA. Okay, each Monday morning we were around the table, we have different cases, and together we think about what is the best possibility, the best opportunity for such expertise, for such patent portfolio to make money with. It is good for transfer technology, of selling of patent, or maybe it is more valuable to think about establishing a startup, okay? And because we were working very close together, we understand very well what are the main target and objective of the investor, okay? Because we exchange. For us, it is more interesting to out-license the technology, to transfer the technology for such reasons, blah, 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 blah. And the others say, no, for us, it is better to imagine to launch a new startup for such reason, blah, 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 blah. And after we compare the two positions.
SEA would launch a startup.
Yes. SEA is a fund, a seed investment, okay? Alors, very important. SEA decided maybe 15 years ago to put a lot of money in a fund, okay? What is the strategy of the CEA today? When they receive the money from the government, they take a part of the money to put in the fund, okay? And after, they go to other investors, private investors, to raise the amount of money in the fund, okay? When the CEA wants to launch a startup, what is the main condition? Okay, they are shareholder, 15%, mandatory, no discussion.
If I have no shareholder, you can do your job by yourself, but I can't. I don't want to see you anymore. And after that, they negotiate a contract, R&D, for the next 2 years to the next 4 years. Okay, it's with the laboratory. The objective is to support the development of the startup, because part of the team is now embarking in the startup. Part of the team want to stay in the laboratory because it's more comfortable and so on. But and it's very important. And the objective is to reinforce the patent portfolio. During that part of the time, the CEA pay for all the filing. Okay, the new filing. At the end, the investor will have to pay. It's the first shareholder R&D contract, and the third is the royalty. If the startup has success, they will get a royalty. Okay, this is a three main points.
Do you have non-French investors?
Now, yes. It's very new one, because as it is a CS governmental organization, they prefer to have a French investor. But no Chinese investor, for example, clearly. Until 2 years ago, it was forbidden to work with Chinese company, clearly. Today, it's very difficult for a Chinese company to work with a university in France. They have to have an agreement from the what we call the DGSE. It's a service secret and of the government, okay? They say, no, you don't have. Well, there are conditions. Okay, you want to work with our university, okay, you want to develop a project, okay, perfect, you want to manufacture, okay, but one main condition is we want to have a manufacturer in France and you will have the same in China, okay, it is the deal we do, you will have, we want to manufacture in France and we authorize you to have the mirror of the manufacturer in, it's interesting for the foreign company, because to be very close to the R&D center, they benefit all the new development. Okay, it's very interesting for them. It's not just a big deal. I just give you. I don't know when I. It's time now to close. Or?
Yes.
No, just I give you a new project we have now, because in France we have a sovereign fund, okay. The government put 100 million, okay, in the fund, like a patent roll, but it's not patent roll. And what we are doing, it's very interesting what they are doing. It could be an idea for you. They invest, they select startup with high potentiality, okay, and they help the startup to boost the filing of patent, okay. They select the startup, they have a meeting with the startup, they say, yes, in the next 2-3 months, we will be able to deliver 5 to 10 new patents, okay, about your project. We pay for that, the fund, not me, the sovereign fund, pay for that, for the filing of the patent. Because in the next 2 years or next 4 years, they will have a new round with investor, okay? And the investor will have to pay for the package of patents. You understand? It's like a lending, okay? They invest the money, they file the patent, and after that, they take money back when the new round with investor. It seems that you can do such kind of methodology in your university. It's nothing really difficult. You need to have the nice tool, we will discuss after, because if you have no tool, you have a black room, okay? Where I am, where I go, I don't know. But after, you have the expertise, clearly. You have the expert, technology expert. We have PhD, okay? We have BMBA, you have, okay? After, you just to have to work with IP, okay? To combine IP with the technology and business, okay? If you want to send some guy in our company, it's open, okay? And after, you have to do the same. But, and you can develop a lot of services like this one. Because you have a TTO, your government asks you to have a return, okay? But before that, maybe you can sell your services, okay? You can make money until the return of your technology transfer. I stop here because I can continue the day. When I have other presentation after. If you have questions.